In this video, I'll show you one of the strategies that market makers use to simply take the money out of the pocket of most retail traders, metaphorically speaking, of course. Market makers act in all markets and in all time frames, and by deduction, the larger the time frame, the more powerful the market makers, the more money is needed to maneuver the market, and the larger the profit too. All the strategies of market makers revolve around certain psychological flaws that all human beings have, including the market makers themselves. The difference is that they are aware of how these psychological pitfalls function, especially in traders. Basically, market makers need to make other trades think that the market is going in one direction, when in reality, they want to push the market in the exact opposite direction. The reason for that is because even though market makers do have enormous power to maneuver the market, they cannot do that all the time because it takes too much money. That means they must choose specific points to maneuver the market. By maneuvering the market, I simply mean that large traders will buy or sell enormous amounts at specific points in an attempt of tilting the market at a specific direction. The other thing is that market makers don't want to make it obvious that there is something unusual going on in price. So they need to find a way to sneak in their massive market positions. To do all of that, these large traders need to find deep liquidity pools in the market, meaning areas where there is a high concentration of buy or sell orders for whatever reason. This is where retail traders enter the game to help the market makers, unwillingly, of course. The thing is that retail traders, especially the new ones, like to use very simple setups to attempt making a quick buck in the market. They use things like breakout trades, which are terrible for a few different reasons. What retail traders are not aware of, for the most part, is the fact that market makers use this information against the retail traders themselves. What I mean by this is that market makers know where retail traders will put their orders based on the simplistic way they have to trade. This creates those deep liquidity pools that market makers need to get in the market without bringing too much attention, and they have to do that at the expense of retail traders' unawareness of what's going on necessarily. Let me walk you through the process of one type of market manipulation so you can have a taste of how this works in reality. It all begins when retail traders identify a significant high or low in the chart where they can create a simple breakout trade. That's a very basic idea that pretty much all traders learn in the beginning. As price approaches the breakout area, the retail traders tend to get agitated thinking it will be a great trade. That's especially true if they see price moving fast towards the breakout. That's the first psychological trick of market makers. They will purposefully help the market drive quicker towards the breakout to make retail traders believe the breakout trade will work well. So in this case, the market makers will purposefully sell the market towards the low in question to make it look like it's a good idea to make a breakout sell trade in there. This is enough to create a cluster of sell orders at that low. And this cluster of orders is the potential deep liquidity pool. It will become a deep liquidity pool once price hits the cluster of orders. Right, so when price does hit the cluster of sell orders created by many retail traders, there is a burst of liquidity in the market because there are many people trying to sell this market at that point. In other words, since there is a sudden burst in supply, it means there is a sudden burst in the potential for demand as well. The only people that can restore the supply and demand equilibrium back to normal quickly in that situation are market makers. And they will do that by opening very large buy positions exactly where the retail traders are selling. That way they can get in the market with very large positions without being too noticed, even though for us who understand this whole mechanic, the process is pretty obvious. So notice what happened here so far. Market makers helped induce the retail traders to the wrong side of the market, just so they could enter a large position to the exact opposite side. They entered the market at the expense of the unaware retail traders. When the retail traders realize that their short trade idea was not as brilliant as they thought it would be, they begin to change their opinion about the direction of the market very quickly, meaning that they will give up on the short position and they will simply go long for mere impulse. This is a common thing among inexperienced traders. They get too affected by the fluctuations of the market, and they end up letting their emotions hit the trigger for them. Needless to say, market makers love that fact. What happens is that this sudden change in opinion about the direction of the market helps the market makers who are already in the market with a long position. So, rather ironically, the retail traders help the market makers get in the market by the deep liquidity pools, and they help drive the market makers' position to the direction that market makers intended to in the first place. In summary, market makers can get out of the market with insanely large profits, while retail traders will just serve as a catalyst for the whole process. And they will alternate between small wins and small losses, perhaps tending a bit to the losing side. This might seem overwhelming and confusing at first, but it will ensure that you won't be caught in the market manipulation again, because you'll begin to think like a market maker instead of thinking like a retail trader. Observe how much meaning we can extract from simple highs and lows in the chart simply by understanding the role that market players assume and their different positions of power. That's just a fraction of the market maker's behavior, of course. If you learned something useful with this video and you would like to understand how these things work in greater detail, I created a complete video course about the market maker strategy. You can access it in the link available in the video description. If you have any questions, you can contact me in the email address also contained in the video description. If you enjoyed the video and wish to support the channel, please click the like button, subscribe to the channel, share the video, and leave your feedback below in the comment section. If you wish to have access to free educational videos about trading, search the channel for more content. There are about 200 videos with live trades, techniques, and general information about the markets. So thank you very much for watching, and I hope to see you in the next videos. Take care.